here. Jasper, heel. Jasper, put that down. Will you put that down? Oh, I'm so sorry. I think it thinks your toddler's a pheasant. Come on, Jasper. Walk it. That's it. Off we go. Now, listen here. I'm auditioning to be Penelope Keith in an older life. Thank you. I've turned into my mum!
This is our producer, Neris, or as I like to call her, Neris Evans.
As close as you can. You two are very good together.
Well, we had a couple of lessons a few weeks ago. But I'm just saying this is my audition for Strictly, really.
Len Goodman, 7.
I believe that Chris and Alison are here as well.
Not talking! We are teaching our bodies every sinew.
Miranda, what are you doing?
What's that say? Take 3 to tango. Oh, well, it's my mum. You see, she's never listened to my needs, and it really winds me up. Well, doesn't she feel like I'm 34 and I've got my own life to lead now?
So we're going to welcome you now to Miranda, and welcome Miranda to you. And properly raise the roof, because this is like a proper echoey studio as well. And Eggheads is recording next door. And we could ruin it, because it's like really thick, right? So do a proper cheery thing, right, that really ruins it for Eggheads. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Miss Miranda Hart, ladies and gentlemen!
Thank you very much. Oh, hello. Bless you, someone just randomly waving at me. That was lovely, if not a little disturbing. Hello, you seem a very lovely audience. Thank you very much for coming to the recording. We couldn't do the shows without you, so we're very grateful that you're here. And I just wanted to come out and I'll be introducing you to the cast. And very much hope you enjoy the show. We're very excited. So, are you excited? 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 We won't go round, it would be boring. It would just be silly and boring, wouldn't it? You look very excited, sir, you're right. Don't get nervous, sorry. I'm not gonna start flirting with you or anything. I just sometimes get a bit overexcited in male company. It's a boarding school thing. I was starved of male company for years. Still now, when a bloke says hi, I think, nice spring wedding! He's even more scared now. So let me crack on and introduce you to our fabulous cast. So first up, will you go wild? Will you go crazy? It's Sarah Hadland! Look at that. Say hello.
Hello.
Off you pop. Lovely. Like twins separated at birth. It's lovely, isn't it? Next up, playing Gary, will you give a huge warm welcome for Tom Ellis? Yay! That was some run. Hello. Would you like to say anything? My show. Okay, off you go. I quite like that manly run, didn't you? It's quite good. Next up, playing Clive in the waiter in the restaurant, who is more interested in... Yeah, wait for your manly run. Wait there, you've got to do a manly run. James Holmes! Very good. Very good. Next up, playing my permanently disappointed and very eccentric mother, Penny. We have a fantastic actress. I won't make her do a manly run, because that would just be odd. Will you give a very warm welcome to the wonderful actress, the star that is, Patricia Hodge! Run! Come on, run! Patricia Hodge! Finally, playing Tilly, my bossy boarding school friend, give a huge, warm, another Egghead's ruinous applause for the comic legend that is Sally Phillips! Very good running. Right, that's the intro. That's my cast. Lovely. Hello, DVD buyers and viewers. Thanks for purchasing. One is very flattered. So I thought I'd do a little set tour. Be a good DVD extra, wouldn't it? This here, forthwith, is the joke shop where I be working in the show. Stevie, of course, always sits behind the till with a cup of tea. If I was to be Sarah Hadland, I'd have to lose a foot and shrink half my body weight and become blonde, and then I might become her sitting there behind.
Got to stop doing that in formal situations.
Our favourite joke shop prop probably is the Roo. We love him a little bit too much. Well, I do. He's my friend, and he gives me a good cuddle, good pre-show cuddle. That's nice. It's a bit much, isn't it? I mean, we're just a little shop that sells.
Shush and submit.
Humpty, that we like to think was the real Humpty Dumpty from Play School. He wasn't. We like to think he was. These, of course, were in episode 2, when I hilariously did some little movements with the pirate sword.
Let's take things a little bit more seriously.
Of course, Captain! Stay back, or I'll throw you to the sex-starved men below. Oh, sorry, Mum. Chattering teeth, hilarious. Little cat. Attention to detail. I battered a man out of the shop with one of these once in a Valentine's Day display anger. That was quite fun. Met him on the day and then battered him out with a cushion. Oh, we've got a lovely relationship that we're showing off about, have we? Oh, I'm so in love. Well, get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. I don't know who St. Valentine was, but I hope he died alone, surrounded by couples. Patricia Hodges' scenes require her basically coming into the shop and going out again. So she spends a lot of time on her what I call wall.
Buongiorno. I won't go as far as proud, but I am genuinely impressed. You are actually going what I call abroad.
We're now into my flat, bang next door to the joke shop. Obviously, in the actual show, logistically, it's up those stairs. So my flat, which is probably my favourite set. Some eggs with bow ties there. we did an orchestra flashback where I had, I was conducting some wooden spoons and some eggs, and they remained a fixture. I tell you what, I mean, that's a hard-boiled egg that's been there for 6 weeks. There's always this. They always dress in just a massive slice of cake. I'm permanent. That's the theme, is that I am permanently eating, which, as I say, deeply unflattering and rude, essentially. Funny. I'm a little scared, neither one prepared. So we've got a sink, we've got the kitchen table, which we've never used, actually. We never sat around this table. Interesting. Of course, here, this is where I sprayed Peter Davison with orange juice from a fridge. Chucked it over him there. Which we'd never done till on the night. So that was slightly unnerve-wracking. Unnerve-wracking? Nerve-wracking for us all. So don't you bring me down today! Oh, Mr. Clayton, it burnt! Oh, gosh, I am so sorry, sir.
Hey, come on now. Call me Keith.
Keith. This is my bedroom, which stops once you come round the door. Doesn't actually exist. Doesn't exist, my bedroom. But I very much like the fact we've got a hint to it being a lovely dressing with a lamp and a nice curtain. Picture there of Laura and Heidi with the dog, not dissimilar to my dog, Peggy. It's that attention to detail that makes this show okay. And here's the restaurant.
You love that coat stand.
This is the coat stand which I wanted to, in every single episode, fall over, crash, carry out. Wasn't allowed to. Because I am one cool, hip chick. Where Gary works, the lovely Gally, the lovely Tom Ellis. He does a lot. I don't think I've ever been behind the bar. It's quite fun there. This is where Tom Ellis and James Holmes, playing Clive, spend their time. I love having a chef friend.
What, because you appreciate fine food?
It's more that it's free food, Gary. Free food! On that sombre and funny note, why don't you just have a flip back to all the sets? Goodbye to you.